Understanding pH is a game changer for every gardener, whether you're tending raised beds of vegetables or containers of flowers on the patio. pH determines how well your plants can absorb essential nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, and iron. If your soil's pH is off, these nutrients become locked up, which means your plants can't access them and they struggle to grow. It's like having $1 million in the bank, but you don't have the key. So what is pH? The pH of things is one of the mysteries of daily life. pH comes up in conversations about winemaking, cheese, swimming pool water, and garden soil. It's a measure of how acidic or alkaline something is, expressed as a number called pH. Now, what's really being measured is the concentration of hydrogen ions. The more hydrogen ions, the more acidic it is. Now, think of pH as a flavor scale. For wine, it decides if it's zesty or smooth. For cheese, it determines if it's tangy or mellow. In swimming pools, pH keeps the water just right for a dip. And in gardening, pH helps plants get the nutrients they need to thrive. To measure pH, we use a scale similar to the Richter scale for earthquakes. The pH scale is logarithmic, meaning it's not linear like a ruler. Each number on the scale represents a tenfold difference in hydrogen ion concentration. For example, soil with a pH of 5 is 10 times more acidic than soil with a pH of 6. If this sounds like a foreign language, don't worry. The pH scale developed by a clever scientist ranges from 0 to 14. Now, this graph shows the pH value of common items. Neutral is right in the middle at 7. Anything below 7 is acidic, like sour, and anything above 7 is alkaline or sweet. For example, looking at this graph or chart, lemon juice has a low pH of 2, while baking soda has a higher pH of 8.5. If you've ever made muffins, you know that adding baking soda to the batter reacts with acid, like orange juice, to help them rise. And that's why recipes and all the things we do in the kitchen is like one big chemistry experiment. Now, balancing your soil pH is crucial because it determines how easily plants can absorb essential nutrients from the soil. And this directly impacts plant growth and health. For example, have you ever been disappointed with the performance of your vegetables or flowers, even though you gave them the best care possible? Well, guess what? pH might have been the problem. If the soil is too acid or too alkaline, some nutrients become locked up or unavailable to plants. Remember, it's like having $1 million in a safe deposit box, but you don't have the key. So take a look at this chart of colored horizontal bars. The wider the bar, the more nutrient is available. As the bar narrows or gets skinnier, less nutrient is available to plants. For example, the green bar at the top represents nitrogen. The most nitrogen is available between a pH of 6 and 8. On either side, it begins to diminish. Now, here's what's important. It doesn't mean there is less nitrogen in the soil. It's just locked up because the pH is off. Now let's look at another example. In soil that's too acidic, nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, and on down to magnesium and molybdenum may become less available or hard to get, leading to a host of deficiencies. In soil that is too alkaline, nitrogen and many micronutrients like calcium, magnesium, iron, copper, and zinc may be harder for plants to access, resulting in stunted growth, yellowing leaves, flower drop-off, poor fruiting, and overall poor plant health. Okay, we've learned that when soil pH is too low, that is acidic or sour, or too high, as in alkaline or sweet, nutrients can become locked up and unavailable to plants. Now, whether you're trying to make your soil more acidic, more alkaline, or neutral, like Goldilocks finding the right porridge, remember, adjusting your soil's pH doesn't happen overnight. Be patient. It's a gradual process and should be done carefully and thoughtfully to avoid overcorrection, which can seriously harm your plants for a long time. Always follow the recommended application rates and be a citizen scientist by observing changes in your plants. So looking at this graph more closely, let's find blueberries. Let's see, they prefer a pH between 4 and 5, which means if you want a bumper crop of blueberries, and who doesn't, you need to grow them in acidic soil with a pH around 4.5. This explains why when I moved to Kodiak, Alaska, my first attempt at growing vegetables was a complete flop. Why? Because the local soil has a pH of 4.5, perfect for spruce trees, ferns, and blueberries, but not so great for lettuce, spinach, and beets. But what if you want to grow, say, raspberries? Raspberries prefer a soil pH that's a little sweeter, say in the 5.5 to 6.5 range. Let's look at how to adjust your soil pH. Remember, don't just guess. Refer to your most recent soil test results. You did get your soil tested, right? So to lower pH, elemental sulfur is commonly used because it turns into sulfuric acid, which slowly makes the soil more acidic. The amount of sulfur you need depends on your soil's current pH and the pH you want to reach. Be sure to read the instructions carefully. To raise your soil pH, agricultural lime, such as dolomite lime, is commonly used. It neutralizes soil acidity by reacting with it. Again, the amount of lime you need depends on your soil's current pH and what you're aiming for. Now, wood ash can also raise soil pH, but it should be used sparingly since it can increase pH quickly. Alrighty, now adding a little bit of this and a little bit of that can be confusing. And for some gardeners, it's a hassle. That's where compost comes in. Compost not only provides your plants with a smorgasbord of nutrition and acts as your garden's best defense against pests and diseases, it brings your soil's pH into perfect balance, naturally. Here's what happened to me. I figured that the best way to clean up the paths between my raised beds was to spread sawdust all on top of these pads and prevent weeds from popping up, and it just was easier for, I didn't bring dirt into the house, that kind of thing. So I ordered a truckload of sawdust to be delivered from the local the sawmill. Well, lo and behold, what I introduced, unbeknownst to me, were bazillions of spores of horsetail. the horsetail grew into the raised beds. But over time, as I continued to add compost, the pH began sweetening to a neutral level. The horsetail went away. In other words, they didn't like the higher pH, and it saved me hours of yanking out horsetail out of my raised beds. Phew, it saved me years of struggle. Now remember, gardening's supposed to be fun and not a struggle, so I was grateful for compost. Understanding pH makes all the difference for your garden and for you as the gardener. It affects how well your plants can access nutrients, and getting it right leads to healthier plants and better harvests. Plus, it allows you to garden with less struggle and more ease. Once you master your soil's pH, you'll unlock the secret to vibrant, thriving plants and gardening that's more enjoyable.